you heard of Phil, the fluter of the town of Ballymuck? The times were going hard with him, in fact the man was drunk. So we just sent out a notice to his neighbours one and all, as to how we'd like the company that evening at the ball. And when writing out, he was careful to suggest to them that if they found a hat of his convenient to the door, the more they put in whenever he requested them, the better would the music be for battering the floor. With the toot of the flute and the twiddle of the fiddle, oh, up and in the middle like the hurling on the griddle, oh, up, down, hands around, across and to the wall. Oh, hadn't we the gaiety, it filled the fluter's ball. There was Mr. Dennis Dockerty, who kept the running dog. There was little crooked Paddy from the Tower of Locket Bog. There was boys from every Barney and girls from every art, and the beautiful Miss Brady's in a private ass and cart. Along with them came Bounce and Mrs. Cafferty. Little Mickey Mulligan was also to the fore. Rose, Suzanne and Margaret O'Rafferty, the flower of Aquagullion and the pride of Petrobore. With the tick on the flute, on the twiddle, on the fiddle, oh, popping in the middle like the hurling on the griddle, oh, up, down, hands around, across and to the wall. Oh, hadn't we the gaiety, it filled the fluter's ball. The Garden of Eden has vanished, they say, but I know the lie of it still. Just turn to the left at the bridge of Finney, and stop when halfway to Cuthill. Is there I will find it, I know sure enough, when fortune has come to my call. Oh, the grass, it is green around Bally James Duff, and the blue sky is over it all. And tones that are tender and tones that are gruff are whispering over the sea. Come back, Paddy Reilly, to Bally James Duff. Come home, Paddy Reilly, to me. My mother once told me that when I was born, the day that I first saw the light, I looked down the street on that very first morn and gave a great crow of delight. Now most newborn babies appear in a huff and start with a sorrowful squall, but I knew I was born in Bally James Duff, and that's why I smiled on them all. The baby's a man now, he's toil-worn and tough, still whispers, come over the sea. Come back, Paddy Reilly, to Bally James Duff. Come home, Paddy Reilly, to me. You've heard of Julius Caesar and the great Napoleon too, and how the Kirk militia beat the Turks at Waterloo. But there's a page of history that yet remains uncut, and that's the warlike story of the Slattery's mounted foot. This gallant corps was organized by Slattery's eldest son, a single-minded poacher with a double-breasted gun. Aye, and many a head was opened, aye, and many an eye was shut, when practicing maneuvers in the Slattery's mounted foot. And down from the mountains came the squadrons and platoons, 24 fighting men and a couple of stout gazoons. When going into action, held each musket by the butt, we sang a song and marched along with Slattery's mounted foot. Well, first we reconnoitred round O'Sullivan Shebeen. It used to be the cookhouse, but we called it the canteen. But there we saw a notice which the bravest heart unnerved: all liquor must be settled for before the drink is served. So on we marched, but soon again each warrior's heart grew pale, for rising high in front of us we saw the county jail. And when the army faced about, 'twas just in time to find a couple of stout policemen had surrounded us behind.
And down from the mountains came the squadrons and platoons, more than 20 fighting men and a couple of stout gazoons. When going into action, held each musket by the butt, we sang a song and marched along the Slattery's mounted foot.